Darling, you send me. I know you send me. Darling, you.
Welcome back to another video. In this week's video, I'm having my last trip from this exchange summer, or my summer abroad in France. I'm going to visit Èze, which is a little town in Fragonard, which is a perfume like factory, and I think it's going to be really cool. Yesterday we went to Monaco, and that was supposed to be like the biggest trip that we were going to have. I honestly enjoyed others more, but it was cool, and especially when I got to see like the hotel where they filmed the Monte Carlo movie with Selena Gomez. I loved it. It was really cool. But hey, it's another day. Yesterday, since we were all late, well, not all. I was not late. My friends were not late, but other people in our group were late to the sort of curfew for when we leave. They reduced the curfew at night, so we regularly have curfew at 11:30, but now we had curfew at 8, so it was not really cool because it was a Saturday night and we could not do anything. But today I will hurry up to make sure we do not get reduced curfew again. So, I'm here back doing a voiceover. I feel like it has been forever since I haven't done a voiceover, and I'm not really here to like explain anything. I just kind of like want to talk about like the footage that I have, because now that I look back at it, I'm like, oh my god, such beautiful moments, like such beautiful memories, and I just want to explain and share those memories with you. For example, here I'm probably fighting with my friend Alda because he was always like joking around, and he made this trip amazing. Okay, so this is Le Musée International de la Parfumerie, and that just means like the International Museum of Perfumes. And honestly, it was a little bit boring. I have to say, I'm not a huge fan of perfume. I love perfume. I wear perfume every day, but I'm not necessarily passionate about the history of perfume and everything. So I only walked around, took aesthetic videos and pictures of like the stuff that was there, and that was about it. If you ask me today, what do you learn about perfume? I have no idea.
Thank you.
la tienda.
Comercial.
A ver.
Trópico. ¿Ya estás grabando?
Sí, ya estoy grabando.
Ay, espera, no puedo abrirlo. Uy, ya.
Okay. Uy, qué fresco.
Sabor verde.
Con todo el calor.
Sabor verde.
No, pero ponle pasión. Ponle pasión. A ver, otra vez.
Otra vez. Pero me vas a... No, ¿van a hacer otro video?
O sea, sigo grabando.
Ok, ok. And after the museum, we just walked around Grasse for like around an hour, and it was absolutely beautiful. Like, all of the little towns in the south of France are magical. In general, the south of France, it's absolutely stunning. Like, it's one of my favorite places on earth. I love it. I really, sincerely, with my whole entire heart, I love the south of France. And like, if you could go any place right now, you should go to the south of France. You will not regret it. The south of France during the summer, I may say, during the summer, it's heaven. You will love it. I have never really been like emotionally attached to a movie except for like Toy Story or Up, but like Mamma Mia, it's really a movie that hits really close home now after the summer, because I truly 100% felt like I was in Mamma Mia, you know, like all the ABBA songs and the summer and the Mediterranean and like being young and wild and free and with your friends. Like, I really want to start crying because I'm growing up and these things are not going to happen like a lot in the future. Let's get in position. And that is it for this week's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This was my last trip with My friends in here in the school, with the staff in the school, and in the French coast. The next trip that I have is in Paris. I'm like really nostalgic about it. Like, it's fun. I'm not gonna cry right now. I had an amazing day, especially considering that yesterday I went to Monaco and I was super excited about Monaco. And then it was one of the most boring things ever. And today we went to this little small town that I had never heard before, and it's probably super underrated because it's absolutely beautiful. And I bought so many things there. I saw such beautiful views, like views that I think I will never ever see in my life ever again. And not to be pessimistic, but this like one in a lifetime things that you only see and then remember for your entire life. Today was one of like those days when you're like, oh my God, this is going to be like such a core memory because it's so beautiful and I'm with such beautiful people and I'm having so much fun and I'm so grateful that I get to experience these things. A little bit sad that, you know, they are going to be memories at some point, but grateful that they are my memories and part of my life. So that was beautiful. The not so beautiful part is that I wasted so much money. Like, I think it was the day that we wasted the highest amount of money. And honestly, I do not regret it. I think it was worth it. Everything that I bought, I'm super happy about it. We are going to ask Elena. Elena, please come here. And this is not a hecky, it's a mosquito bite. Okay.
Hi.
How do you feel about the amount of money that you spent today?
A little bit regretful, but not so much. A little bit like ashamed.
Ashamed. But ashamed. I think you would regret more. No. You would regret more not buying the things that you bought.
Right. Ashamed a little bit. Regretful, yeah, me too. Not so much.
That's exactly how I feel. And I mean, to be honest, probably if I ever have like another experience like this trip, I will have to pay for it and I will have to pay for everything. So I'm using the privilege that I'm still under my parents' tuition and I'm not paying for my life so far. So I'm gonna show you what I bought. And number one, we went to a perfume like museum, which I didn't really care because I'm not really like a huge fan of perfumes. Like, I do not like people to smell bad, definitely. And I love to smell like good, but I'm not like a fan of perfumes. Like, I don't collect them or stuff like that. So for me, it was interesting, but not like the best. The best was when we arrived to this little town. It's called S. Most beautiful place ever. Siena, Saint-Paul-de-Vence, S, and Mougins are my top three cities. And of course Cannes, but well, those make you feel like you're in the Beauty and the Beast, like literally. And there in S, I went to this shop, which was really weird, but a shop that only sells products made with mandarins. And I bought a chocolate like spread, like if it was Nutella, but it has citron, and citron, it's lemon or lime, it's lime. And here in France, they grow limes in Menton, which is another city that I already visited. I did not make a video about it, but you can go watch some pictures about Menton in my Instagram. And this is like a sort of Nutella, but with like, I forgot that word. Oh, with like lime or citron. And it was so good. And my brother like loves Nutella. I love Nutella. Who doesn't love Nutella? So I bought the spread for my house. And it came with this like little cute baggie. So I'm gonna gift it to my brother in this. I also bought this necklace. It's so beautiful because it has like this really cute chain and a sun and like white here. It's so cute and it matches these earrings that are not mine. These are Elena's, but I think this looks really good. And we went to a perfume factory that's called Fragonard. And in Fragonard, they make perfumes and then they sell it cheaper than in the Fragonard stores because it's a factory. So maybe that's just marketing. I really don't know. I still spend a lot of money there, but it's super cute. And the designs are so pretty. Like, if you want to study fashion design or something, you should dedicate your life to, like, packaging, like design packaging. It's beautiful. So I bought two, not perfumes, eau de toilette. I'm not pretty sure that's how you pronounce it. Oh, como dirías, eau de toilette. No, it's the same, but I want to pronounce it right. It's not a parfum, it's an eau de toilette. Probably that's terrible, but still, I bought this one for my mom. Look at the packaging, it's so pretty. And it was like way cheaper than like any other sort of like brand name perfume that you could buy. And it's called Star Etoile. I really don't know how you pronounce this word, but I know that it means star. The packaging is beautiful. The perfume smells magnificent. And this is for my mommy. I'm gonna show you the packaging, look. And it's by Fragonard. They showed us about like how to make perfumes, and they talked to us about like the people that make the perfumes and everything. So I found it very interesting, very unique. It's not something that you get any other place than France, or at least we do not have Fragonard in Mexico, and you do not get the whole entire Fragonard experience in Mexico. And I bought this for me, which is another eau de toilette. And it's in the parfum Fleur de la Passion. And it's so good. It smells, I don't know, it smells so good. And the lady there told me that this is like a special edition and they only made it this year and they will not make it any other time. So if I didn't buy it, like buy it, if I did not buy it like right now, I was not going to ever be able to buy it again. So I did, and it smells so good. And this is for me. Oh, it smells so freaking good. And the packaging, it's so beautiful. So yeah, that's what I bought today. I'm not mad about spending my money. I also bought a crepe and it was so delicious. And it was an amazing day. I'm honestly so proud of today. And I'm so glad that this was my last trip and that it was an amazing trip. So now I have to get ready to go eat dinner and go to the beach. And well, that is it for this week's video. Do not forget to subscribe on the little red button. Follow me on all of my social media. Leave any comments if you guys have any. And thank you so much for the love and support. I'll see you next week. Bye bye.
¿Quieres decir adiós?
Bye.
Sí, traes ropa, ¿verdad? Sí. Ok, espera.